Hey Gemini, Alice here with your weekly reading for the week of March 14th to the 18th. This week, we're going to look at the incoming energies for you, the energies around somebody who's around you, and the energy of the connection between you and this person. And then we'll just find out. We'll go from there and see what happens. Technically, this reading is timeless, so whenever you find it is when you're meant to find it. There could be some message here for you. I mean, time is... I'm not actually going to go into that. I'm not even going to bother speaking about that. Then the intro will be way too long. Just, you know, time is like all over the place. We're in different points in time and all that. So, yeah. Anyways. Just keep in mind this is a general reading, so not everything is going to apply to your situation. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't try to force it. You can always check out your other signs, your sun, moon, rising, or Venus signs. There may be some messages in there for you as well. Or, you know, just anything that you feel drawn to. I mean, I'll be honest with you, the signs, it's not like... I'm not an astrologer or anything like that. It's just to help me focus energy. I mean, I could have easily just made this video for everybody who has green eyes. It's just to help me, you know, so it's not so broad in general. I don't know how people do that. I mean, maybe one day I'll figure it out, but yeah, I don't know how to do that. All right, so Gemini, what's going on for you this week? What is going on for Gemini this week? What are the current energies for Gemini this week? When I say that, current energies, it's like, okay, so right now, this is what, the way how events are happening, this is what could be happening for you this week. Although, you know, later today, maybe something big changes, somebody uses their free will, and then it can just fucking change everything. So, eh. That's why I say, you know, take these readings, like, you know, whatever resonates and all that, and whenever you find it, you know, because time, you know, things change. Okay. Does that want to come out? Why? Why? Ew. Who wants this? Ew. Three of Swords. This is finding out some truth that fucking hurts. Ew. Either... Okay. This is just an energy here. So either you're going to hurt somebody else's feelings or somebody has hurt your feelings. I hate starting readings with such fucking bad energy. Like, dude. I don't know what that's about. That can just be somebody around you, too. This doesn't have to be you. Like I said, you may have unintentionally hurt somebody's feelings. Gemini, it's possible. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. What's the overall energy? Oh, I see. Okay. The Tower. Okay. And the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Why can't I get, like, a happy reading? This is not boding well. This is not starting off on a good start here. This can be your energy. This can be the energy around you. This can be somebody else's energy that's around you. Either way, shit is going down. This is... These two cards, I'm going to tell you now. These two cards mean unfortunate. Fucking bad luck. Like, this is... I mean, I'm not going to sugarcoat this. This is bad. Yeah, this is something that you can't help. If this is happening to you, there's nothing you can do about it. It's out of your control. Shit is happening. The Tower is like, it's like something that comes in really quick and is just ruining shit around you. Like something around you. It doesn't matter. Like, I mean, because this is the overall energy. It's either it's happening directly to you, or it's happening to somebody that you know, or it's in your environment around you. There's something that is unfortunately happening, and it's going to ruin something. I don't know what it is. It's just the energy here, but whatever it is, it's something that really can't be prevented. The Wheel of Fortune in reverse, this is the universe, and there's just something that is happening, external forces that cannot be helped. Now, you know, that explains this Three of Swords. There's a lot of heartache here. A lot of pain, a lot of heartache here. I don't know if this is you or this is somebody else. Okay, Gemini. Let's see. What's the incoming energy for you this week? We have the Ten of Coins in reverse. We have the King of Coins in reverse. We have the Two of Coins in reverse. Don't be scared by all the reversals. The energy that's coming in. There is somebody who. There is an energy of a mistake. A mistake that is costing security. Because these two cards, usually when they're upright, it's feeling very secure, feeling very stable, especially financially. I feel like this may have to do with money. It can be. It can have something to do with family as well. There's a mistake that's being made here that's coming in. Some sort of yeah, that is rocking the stability of either family and or a financial situation here. Yeah. This is the incoming energy for you, Gemini. So this is coming towards you this week. It can also be somebody who this can be a very possessive energy as well. The King of Coins can be very possessive about finances. All right, I'll clarify this later, but let's see what the energy is like for somebody who's around you. Page of Wands. Okay. King of Cups in reverse. And the Six of Cups. Okay. This person, their energy is quite carefree, worry-free, a little childish, a little actually very childish. Not even a little. This person is acting like a child. And I'm not, it's not in a cute way. No. This person, they're throwing a tantrum. From this, I get a tantrum. They're throwing a tantrum. This person is like, okay, the Page of Wands, what I get from this is somebody who just does whatever the fuck they want. I want to do that, so I'm gonna go do that. You know? Like, they don't even really think about it. They just fucking do it. You know? Like, look at her. She's just doing whatever the fuck she wants. I think that's a her. I don't know. Her, him, whatever. They're just doing whatever the fuck they want. You know, I'm gonna run around with my shirt off. Who gives a fuck? What she got in her hands? Or he, or whatever. I don't know. I don't know. I got this thing. I'm waving around. Woo! Like, I'm gonna do whatever the fuck I want. I don't give a shit. That's this person's energy. And they're doing it because it's almost like they're trying to. I don't want to say like they're trying to get back, but it's very, it is like a sort of a petty energy. Like it's like, I'm getting back at you, so I'm gonna do whatever. It's not like I'm getting back at you. Kind of, but it's just this energy of like, they know that they should be better. You know, they know, you know, you're a grown up, because I feel like they're older. So it's like, you know you shouldn't be acting this way, but they're acting this way, and they're like, oh, I'll give a shit, and they're gonna throw a tantrum about it. This person. The Six of Cups. Yeah, it's just, I get a lot of, like, this can be the way that they've always acted. That this is, like, the way that they used to act when they were a kid. I get that too. Like, I just get a lot of like reverting back to childish ways. Maybe they're having a midlife crisis. I get that too. They're just, yeah, I don't know. It's weird. Okay, what's your connection? What's the energy within the connection with you and this person? Gemini. We have the Magician in reverse. Okay. We have the High Priestess. Okay. And we have the Ace of Coins in reverse. I feel like something didn't happen here between you guys, but it was like close to happening. Like the High Priestess, like I feel like there are secrets being kept here, hidden from each other, or it can be that the connection itself is a secret, like that you hide it from people. Maybe, I don't know, maybe Gemini, you don't want people to know that you are connected to somebody who's this young and childish, who like acts this young and childish. I don't know. There's just something that is not out in the open about this connection. With the Magician and the Ace of Coins both in reverse, I feel like that... It's like something was supposed to happen here in this connection. Like something was planned out and it was supposed to happen, but it didn't happen for some reason. It might have something to do with this tower over here. Something like it, I feel like it's something that was perhaps out of your control, out of both of your control, and maybe your person is acting in this way because they, you know, you can't do anything about it. Like, whatever is happening over here, there's nothing you can do about it. It's just happening. And perhaps this person here, this is how they're dealing with it. That's what I said. It feels like a midlife crisis here. This is how they're dealing maybe with this tower over here. This is how they deal with it. And I feel like, yeah, there's something in this connection that was meant to happen. Like, you planned for something. I don't know why, like, I'm hearing, this seems very specific, but, like, it's like you plan to, like, get married or something, or you plan to move in together or something like that, if it's a connection like that. But because something happened out of your control, that didn't happen. And now there's this energy. You know, hurt feelings. Okay, let's clarify. I want to know a lot of things. So where do I start? Let's start here at the very beginning. That's a very good place to start. Okay. Never mind my Sound of Music references. All right, Ten of Coins. Tell me about the Ten of Coins. Okay, what is this? Oh, the Lovers in reverse. Okay, the Page of Cups in reverse. Okay, I feel like there's something financially going on here. I feel like this tower has something to do. It can do with money. It can do with family. Whatever it is, whatever this incoming energy is, it is emotional. I feel it can be fueling that Three of Swords energy. There are a lot of like emotions behind this, and like when I say emotions, I mean like high emotions, like it's upsetting type of emotion. The Lovers, there's a connection here, a strong connection here that it's not going very well. And this Ten of Coins is sort of the result of that. So whatever's going on down here, I feel is connected here. It's not always connected. The incoming energy hasn't always been connected to the person, which is really strange. Like, not directly, but I feel it's more directly connected. I feel like you and this person, whatever didn't happen here, is now affecting an incoming energy here, this Ten of Coins. So it's, there can be something wrong with family, like maybe if it was like a marriage or something like that that didn't happen, then because of that, maybe there's some discord in the family. Maybe, you know, maybe there are something like disagreements going on there. I mean, I do feel like it has to do with money. So also, if it was a wedding, if there were like, you know, like down payments or whatever on like places like to have the wedding or a reception and all that, it's a money issue, you know, who gets what money, like, you know, who paid for what. I mean, I get a lot of that. I get a lot of money issues going on here. I don't know why. I mean, maybe it's because there's so many pentacles up here. It doesn't have to be money. That is just one thing that I'm getting here. Let's see about this King of Coins. Who is this King of Coins? What do you want to tell me about this King of Coins? Because I'm getting, I don't know, I'm also getting like somebody who's older. Like I'm getting that there's somebody here who's not happy, who's kind of like, I don't know why I'm getting a father figure there. Somebody who provided and is kind of upset about that. Like, you know, it's like I gave money and like I kind of want my money back. I get that energy from this King of Coins. But tell me about the King of Coins. Yeah. Okay, yeah, thank you. Ten of Pentacles in reverse and the Ten of Swords. Yeah, like I do feel like this person is upset. This King of Coins person is upset because they're upset because directly with this Ten of Coins. There's a bit of a web going on here. I'm trying to keep it like together in my head. So this here is the connection. This is the Lovers. Something happened here. Something that was supposed to happen that didn't happen here. And it's and that is what's causing this incoming energy of this Ten of Coins. I feel like that maybe family, finances, and family. Somebody is upset within the family. I feel this King of Coins is connected to that. This, I feel, is a father figure of some sort. Somebody who provides, basically. Somebody who provides money. And they are in pain. They might have done something impulsively that is causing this pain. Something that they wouldn't normally do. I feel. What else can you tell me? Five of Cups in reverse. Yeah, they're feeling a loss here. I feel like it's a loss of money, to be honest. They feel regret over something that they did. I feel it's related to money. It's something that they provided, some sort of money that they provided. Yeah, let's see about this Two of Coins. I want to know about this Two of Coins. Tell me about the Two of Coins. Sorry, I'm like not really spending like a whole lot of time talking because I know I can talk for fucking hours. I have talked for fucking hours. So I'm trying to like move things along and not like get so stuck into things. It's like my new kind of thing that I'm trying out. So if it seems like, oh, I moved on really quickly from that, it's because I don't really like want to dwell on it because I know I could. And yeah, it's not like a personal reading that's going on for hours and hours. So okay, Nine of Wands in reverse. And the Five of Pentacles. Okay. Okay, so yeah, again, I feel like there was a mistake. There's a mistake that was made that's causing a lot of this incoming energy. Or the incoming energy is that there is a mistake. It has to do with somebody got left out. Somebody who wasn't supposed to be, possibly. Oh, King of Wands. Yeah. They did not want to be left out. Oh, they did not want to be left out. The King of Wands is somebody who usually, you know, they get their way, they get whatever they want, and somebody left them out in the cold. Possibly you, possibly, yeah. I feel like that is that King of Coins, person as well. I feel like they're the same person. They got left out of the loop here, and that was kind of a mistake for not letting them know what was going on. But the reason why they were left out of the loop is because this Nine of Wands in reverse, it's like it just would have added more tension to the problem or to the issue that's going on here. Because I feel like this issue is between you and this person, this other person, this person. And I felt like it feels like you didn't want to involve another person because that would just add more tension to the situation. But this person found out and they did not want to be left out, and yeah, it's resulting in this. Okay, that's the incoming energy for you this week. Now let's see about this person here. I want to know about this fucking King of Cups. Tell me about this King of Cups. This, I don't know, this childish, like t throwing a tantrum type of energy here. What's this King of Cups about? Seven of Cups in reverse and the Empress. It's under the M. Oh, and the Emperor. Okay, this is the two of you. I was like, is this you or is this them? And then I got my answer. The Empress and the Emperor. You're the Empress. They're the Emperor. It's just energy, you know, feminine, divine masculine. Because the lovers is here. So I'm like, well, one of you is the DF and one of you is the DM here. So I feel like you, Gemini, you're the DF because you're upright. And I, you know, I don't see your energy here, but I see their energy here. And their energy is somebody who's not in control of themselves. The King of Cups is not in control of his emotions. So yeah, the reason why I feel they're like this, like, or what's fueling this tantrum and all that is because you seem to be fine. Like, you seem to have things under control. You're being quite mature about the situation, I feel. I get that energy off the Empress. Well, and you're like this. It's like somebody has to be the person who, you know, has their head on their shoulders because the Emperor, this person, they've fucked off for whatever reason. They're having their whatever midlife crisis going on here. They're going reverting back to when they were like a kid or a teenager or something. And yeah, they're like this. It's with the Seven of Cups, they're just confused. They're very confused about things. They don't really know like what to do. Yeah, Eight of Cups in reverse, or not reverse, just the Eight of Cups. They might feel like you're walking away, that you're getting away, that you've moved on. Ace of Swords, the more confusion. Ace of Swords in reverse. These are too confusing. They're very confused about like where you're going because they see you as the Empress. You know, I mean, you understand yourself. And you may have walked away from this, or like they just think like, why are you so calm about all this? I mean, I don't know if you're actually calm, but to them, this is their perspective of you. I mean, you might be losing your shit too. I don't know, but this is how they see you. They see you as like that. Okay. Tell me about this High Priestess. I want to know more about the High Priestess. Tell me about the High Priestess. Justice and the Nine of Swords in reverse. I feel like it's almost like the two of you have decided, or not decided, but like that it's better not to talk about things, or not to like to keep things to yourselves, to keep this stuff about your connection to yourselves. That's the energy that I get here. It's like you've thought about it, and you've realized kind of like this is the best way to go about things is to just kind of not, don't talk about Fight Club. I feel like that is what was going on here and up here. It's like you didn't want to involve anybody else in this, and somebody kind of felt like they should have been involved in some way, and they felt like, why did you leave me out, type of thing. And that's why they're kind of coming in with this energy, and you're gonna have to deal with that. But I do feel like the two of you, like whatever this connection, it's like you've been keeping it a secret, keeping this shit a secret, because you kind of felt like that, was what should be done. Okay, I want to know about this magician then in reverse. Tell me about the magician. Tell me about the magician. What flipped up in here? Oh, okay, yeah, two cups in reverse. Yeah, it's something separated this connection. There was something that was planned, and there's a separation. Oh yeah, Wheel of Fortune reverse. Yes, it does have to do with this energy here. Something. Oh, here. Yeah, four of wands in reverse. I knew it. I fucking knew it. Like, okay, sorry. Sorry, I get excited when I see things where I'm like, yes, I fucking knew it. I think I bumped the camera. Okay. I said that something was meant to happen. There were plans that were meant to happen, but they didn't happen. Four of Wands. Four of Wands is something, some sort of event. That's why usually it's tied to weddings and marriages. With the Two of Cups showing up in reverse, I mean, I feel like there was some sort of event or wedding or something that was supposed to happen, that was planned to happen, that didn't happen. And it wasn't anybody's fault. With the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, it was nobody's fault. It's just things happen. Shit happens, in the universe. And I feel like it was canceled because of something. Maybe it was canceled because of COVID. Maybe it was canceled because there's a war going on. Maybe it was canceled because of some other reason. Maybe the finances didn't come through, maybe you didn't get the place that you wanted. Maybe, it wasn't guaranteed that you would get the booking or something of the whatever the place for wherever this event was supposed to be. And that shit is nothing that you can do about it. There's You don't have any control over it. So however these plans fell through, there was like, it was nobody's fault. It wasn't you or this person's fault. Okay. All right, tell me about this Ace of Coins then in reverse. I'm not saying like that you guys have broken up or anything like that. I don't really get that. I mean, I don't know what happened, to be honest. I mean, yeah, I know the Lovers in reverse. That doesn't automatically mean that you've broken up. I mean, that just means that there's something wrong in the connection. It can be communication. It could just be, things just aren't balanced right now. I mean, I don't even get a feeling that you guys are not together. It's just something didn't happen. I mean, two of cups in reverse, that just means there was no union happening. Like, it can be a wedding, that's what I mean. But, and there was like a separation, but I don't like really feel like it's complete, yeah, this person's going through shit, but yeah, anyways. Ace of Coins reverse. Alice, shut up. Ace of Coins in reverse. Talk too much. So I've been told. I've been told I talk too much, and I've been told I don't talk enough. Funny enough. And they're both pretty equal. Page of Cups. And Knight Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, something like there's like a loss of potential here. I feel you both feel you've missed out on some sort of potential here in this connection. It can be that maybe too careful planning, being a little too cautious about things, possibly. I get a bit like just things didn't really change. I mean, obviously, if this didn't happen, you know, nothing really changed here. I still forget that there are feelings here. The Page of Cups, despite missing an opportunity, there's still feelings here. There's still emotions here. Okay, there's still a lot of emotions. Queen of Cups. Yeah. You want to tell me more? Okay, the Devil. Yeah. So, there are issues that need to be addressed here, about this potential that has been missed, because of other circumstances here. I feel like there may be an emotional conversation that needs to happen, but something is holding this connection back. Tell me about this Devil. I want to know about the Devil. Give me a card about the Devil. Yeah, okay, yeah, there it is. Three of Swords. Thank you, Spirit. And Two of Pentacles. Yep, we come back up to here. Yeah, this person up here. Whatever this is. It doesn't have to be the person, but it's just the fact that the Two of Coins in reverse here, this tension. And like it goes back to like wanting to keep people out of it, only wanting to deal with the situation yourselves. It's kind of hurt people's feelings. I kind of don't even think this is you guys, to be honest. I mean, yes, I feel you guys can be hurt about the situation and about everything, but I think that there are other people that got their feelings hurt here, and it's there's toxic behavior that is here. I don't even really feel like it's your toxic behavior or even this person. I mean, yes, this is a little toxic to be kind of having your stupid midlife crisis while you seem to have your shit together and your person has fucking lost their shit a little bit here. They're just, you know, acting like a child. But yeah, I do feel there is that toxicity around the connection here. Because, you know, it's because of this mistake here of not telling people or not including other people, that maybe should have been included. I don't know. Anyways, let's see what the universe has to say. What does the universe have to tell you, Gemini? Because I don't really have any other questions about anything here specifically. So let's just see, what does the universe want to tell you, Gemini? Message for you, directly to you. What does the universe want you to know? What do you need to know right now, basically? All right, Gemini. All seems very oddly specific. I thought something fell. Didn't fall. Okay. Oh, it just turned in my hand. That's why. Four Swords in reverse. You may feel like you're having a hard time shutting your mind down, like shutting your brain down, like feeling kind of restless in your head. Like thinking about things a lot. I mean, it just wanted to show itself. It didn't want to like come out. Just like, hey, this energy is present. Say with the King of Swords, you may feel like you have to make all the decisions right now. That, you know, you're the one who has to kind of do everything. Okay. Why is it so many? No. That's like a gazillion cards. Come on. Come on, universe. Like, you're giving me little bits and pieces of things. Okay, here we go. Thank you. See, when I complain, then it just gives me three cards. I'm like, thank you. That's what I wanted. All right. So, we have the Six of Wands. We have the Lovers. And we have the Sun in reverse. And then we've got the Ten of Swords. All right. So what does the universe want to tell you, Gemini? Overall energy here. Yes, this is painful. I feel like the universe wants, you know, it's like, I understand this is a painful situation to be in. I do get a bit of, see, like the Lovers was in reverse here, but now it's upright. And it's almost like, yes, going through this pain, because the Ten of Swords will reset to an Ace of Swords. And I feel like it's painful right now to be in this connection, but it is upright. And I do get this feeling that, you know, that there is, the connection is strong. There is a strong connection here. With the Six of Wands, I get, like, the way she looks very, determined, you know. I get a, I don't know, like, she just looks like a fucking badass. That's all I see here. Like, she is like, she knows she can do it, kind of thing. And I feel like, you know, that you can get through this too. The Sun in reverse here, there may be a little bit of pretending that things are okay for a while, while you, like, you know, while you're in this sort of energy of trying to get things going in a good direction. It feels like the universe is just trying to tell you that, yes, it's painful right now, but your connection is strong with this person, and you guys will get through it. But there's no doubt about it that, you know, not everything is fucking sunshine and rainbows right now. No shit, right? And you might even just have to put on a happy face for, you know, other people, or even for each other, or for yourselves for a little bit. Until this Ten of Swords can reset to an Ace of Swords. What's underneath this? Yeah, Nine of Coins. This is like, you know, focus on what you want. Like, what is it that brings you joy, that brings you pleasure? Yeah, I mean, that could help heal this Ten of Swords. To, you know, do something that gives you enjoyment, basically, that may help heal this pain that's going on. But I mean, the universe wants to tell you that this connection's strong. Like I told you, like, I wasn't feeling like you guys were broken up. I just feel like something didn't work out. I wasn't getting a strong breakup vibe. So, all right, Gemini, that's your reading for this week. Thanks for watching. If you found this insightful or entertaining or useful in any way, I'd appreciate a like and or subscribe, as that just helps me do more with the channel. Yeah, good luck this week. Good luck with this person, with this King of Coins person. I think it'll be fine. It's just they're just kind of upset that they were left out of the loop. I mean, I feel like you probably know how to deal with this person. They feel very familiar to me, so I feel like it's family, to be honest, or somebody who you've known for a very long time or is like family. So you should be able to deal with that. This sucks, though. I'm sorry about this. That something happened that you couldn't control. I mean, that really sucks, but it looks like things are slowly probably going to work itself out or get better. I didn't say work itself out, but improve. So, yeah. Take care. And I hope you have a good day or good night wherever you are. And I will talk to you later. Bye.